अबाउट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ रूट एपिकल मेरिस्टेम. फर्स्ट थ्योरी वॉज गिवन बाय नेगली विच इज़ एपिकल सेल थ्योरी, बट दिस थ्योरी इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल. द सेकेंड थ्योरी वॉज गिवन बाय द हिस्टोजन हेनस्टीन विच इज़ हिस्टोजन थ्योरी. दिस थ्योरी इज़ नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल इन जर्नल फॉर एंजियोस्पर्म. हाउएवर इन मॉडिफाइड कॉन्सेप्ट डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ जोन्स टेक्स प्लेस आफ्टर सम कंटिन्यूस डिविजन इन अ मेरिस्टमेटिक सेल. दे आर इक्विवेलेंट टू द प्लूरोम पेरिबेलम एंड आउटर लेयर विच मे गिव क्लोज ओनली रूट कैप कैलिप्ट्रोजन और बोथ एपिडर्मिस एंड कॉर्टेक्स. इन एक्वेटिक मोनोकोट इंसिस्टिंग थ्री जोन्स एज अप्लाइड इट इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम द रूट कैलिप्ट्रोजन. नेक्स्ट इज बॉडी कॉन्सेप्ट और क्रैपर कॉपे थ्योरी proposed by the Sweep in 1917 and considered equivalent to the tunica corpus theory. Of stem because it is based on the plane of division. In fact, it is found that in root, in relation to growth and RAM, their basic growth in one region, there is increase in the diameter, forms main body of root. Second, there is decrease in diameter towards root cap. For such type of variable growth, their division occur, which is characterized by first transverse division. Second, out of two daughter cells, one remain undivided and other divided vertically. The region where longitudinal division occur, increase in vertical rows and hence diameter. In the type when head or transfer part of the T is toward RAM, number of vertical rows decrease. As a result, there is decrease in diameter. The part where transverse region of T is away from RAM is called as body, and the region is far from RAM where bar is from RAM is called as the capre. Such type of organization is visible almost in every root. Next is caution center, the silent center. Cell of this region are comparatively larger, showing light stain, having low amount of DNA, RNA and mitochondria. These cells are considered as a result of one of the diploid cell. In fact, in young root which shows growth, such region is not found. It develop later can also found that the wherever surrounding cell get injured, the cell of the caution center divide and act as a meristematic region. This type of structure appear of advantage. There is a great danger in the RAM when it passes through soil. Such cells are also reported. In vitro studies on the other side of pith, where is the T division are clarify visible. Nowadays there are mainly reports which suggest that the such type of center also present in root of pteridophyte like equisetum, most of gymnosperm. So here is the difference between dicot root and monocot root. So a pericycle gave rise to the in dicot root a pericycle gives rise to the internal roots, coke cambium and part of vascular cambium. In monocot root, pericycle produces only lateral roots. Number of xylem and phloem groups limited. In dicot root, the number of xylem and phloem groups are limited, whereas number of xylem and phloem groups are numerous in monocots. Xylem vessel angular or xylem angular polygonal. In transverse section, xylem vessel are oval or rounded in transverse section. Conjunctive tissue parenchymatous. Here in monocots, conjunctive tissue mostly sclerenchymatous, sometime parenchymatous. Pith absent or very small. In dicot roots, pits are absent or and of very small in size. Whereas in monocot root, pith large and well developed. In dicot root, secondary growth occur, but in monocot root, no secondary growth occur. The parenchymatous conjunctive tissue forms vascular cambium. Example, ficus, gram and pea. The conjunctive tissue is in monocots, the conjunctive tissue is sclerenchymatous, so it does not produce vascular cambium, that is colocasia, mucosa and maize. Here are different type of roots. So roots are broadly divided into tap root or adventitious root. So tap, in most of dicot plants, tap roots are present. It is the main root and it originates from the radical and form the primary root. It bear lateral root and several order that are referred to as secondary, tertiary root, etc. Next is adventitious root. In some plant like grass, monocot and banyan tree, first taproot, primary root appear from the radical, but it disappear after some time and the adventitious roots develop. So adventitious roots are not developed from the radical, they develop from some other site. Next is fibrous root. In monocots plants, the primary root is short-lived and is replaced by a large number of roots. These roots originate from the base of stem and considered as the fibrous root. So here are the structure. Next is monocot root. Next is modified root. Modified root, here are the modification of different type of tap roots. First is conical roots, which is present in carrot, which is Daucus. These roots are thick at the upper side and tapering at the base. Fusiform roots or spindle roots, these roots are thicker in the middle and tapering at the both the ends. Example, radish. Napiform roots, tuberous roots and nodulated roots. Napiform, these roots become swollen and spherical at the upper end and tapering at the lower end. Tuberous roots, these roots do not have regular shape and at any position. Nodulated roots, nodules are formed in branches. This type of roots are present in pea, gram. Next is tap root modified for respiration. So इस तरह को तो ये respiration के लिए किसमें present होती है? Mangroves में. Next is modification of adventitious root. So these are fasciculated roots, nodulose root, climbing roots, and there are many different types. Thank you.